We've talked a lot about food, diet, exercise. How important is sleep in the whole picture?
So to me, like, this is how sleep is. Just like everyone's got a cell phone, and every single day you have to charge that cell phone. And when you forget to charge it that one night and the battery dies, and like, oh, man, what am I going to do today? That's what sleep does to your body. Your sleep is your battery charger. Now, unlike how your phone might die, your body won't. But once you hit your battery's on empty, stress is higher. Your metabolism is slower. You overrelease a hormone called cortisol, makes you store fat. So sleep is your battery's charger. And there's two types of sleep. There's deep sleep, and then there's REM sleep. Deep sleep is like, so there's different stages. That's where your body gets repaired. REM is when your mind gets repaired. So a lot of times, like my wife, Abby, she had an injury. She has fibromyalgia. She doesn't sleep as deep as I do. So I can genetically sleep. It's the amount of hours you need is genetic. I can sleep 6 hours a night. Abby needs 8 to 9 hours because she doesn't get the same level of deep sleep and REM sleep that I get. So you have to make sure that you sleep well, because it's not what you eat, it's what you metabolize. So you can do everything else right, but if you're not sleeping well, your body's not gonna work for you.
You mentioned stress too. How does that play into the picture? Because we all feel it.
So stress is an interesting thing, because to me it's the X factor of everything. Okay. You could be sleeping well, eating well, exercising, drinking your water, filling your gas with the right supplements. All of that could be fantastic, and if your stress is off the chart, you're gonna struggle. So when we look at stress causes a release of adrenaline, which is our body's energy, and that gives us energy initially. It's like that initial thing, but then it counters with cortisol. So every time someone stresses, it comes up, and then your body has to relax. Now, what ends up happening is throughout the day, we have these mini moments, you know, stuck in traffic, late for a meeting, these mini boom, boom, boom. And what too many times happens is you're not giving your body enough time to relax, so that cortisol stays in your blood, and that becomes something where your body can't burn fat consistently. So I look at sleep and stress as the bookends. I look at that, number one, it's your food and your exercise, and then water and supplements, and then sleep and stress are really the things that allow you to metabolize and optimize all of that. So you have to manage your sleep and you have to manage your stress.